Hello everyone, and welcome to this meditation to connect with the ancient Egyptian crocodile god Sobek. What to say about Sobek? This is a picture of him that's from one of my decks. This is Horus over here. This is not who we're focusing on today. Can you see this crocodile-headed god here? This is Sobek. So sometimes you see him within crocodile, form of a crocodile, sometimes crocodile-headed man. However, Sobek comes to you, is absolutely fine. To me, Sobek is the king of all things carnal, the god of desire and sating those desires. If you think about the way a crocodile hunts and the way they devour their prey, then the fact that the ancient Egyptians considered Sobek to be the father of all crocodiles perhaps isn't really that surprising. So if you need some help to find some clarity, or you need to figure out what you really want, or even if you just want a nice meditation, I think you'll enjoy it. So if you gather yourself comfortably, I'm going to put my card down but keep the picture of Sobek near my eye, because the Egyptians believed that you could call the god into any statue or image of them. So gather yourself comfortably. As I say with all my meditations, you don't need to work too hard. Just follow my voice. Put yourself at the center of the story. If your thoughts wander or you need to fidget, that's fine. Just come back to my voice and be comfortable. So, when you're ready, sitting or laying down, you can close your eyes and just start to focus on your breathing. Don't need to work too hard. Just relax into your breathing. Just enjoy the sensation of slowly filling your lungs up with air, and slowly letting the air out. Enjoy the relaxed breathing, the sensation of oxygen reaching all around your body, wherever it's needed. Enjoy the sensation of blowing out the carbon dioxide and the energy that isn't needed. Drift into your imagination now. I'd like to visualize that you are standing on the edge of the River Nile. It's dusk. The sun is just setting, making beautiful colours, and it's heading for evening. Smell those beautiful smells of lush vegetation, the flowers that grow near the edge of the Nile. See the peaceful light glistening on the water. As you look down, you notice there's a boat. comfortable looking boat. And you step in, make yourself comfortable, and slip it from its moorings. Allowing it to drift. As it drifts, you feel yourself more relaxed, more comfortable, just drifting on the water. More relaxed, more comfortable, drifting down the Nile gently, trusting that the Nile will take you where you need to go, drifting gently, relaxing, breathing. Don't notice as the boat gently bumps up against a jetty. This jetty is easy to just slip the rope over, climb out. Curiosity piques your interest. Because the jetty leads up to a palace on the edge of the Nile. As you step up onto the jetty, you notice it's quite high. All the jetty leading up to the palace is quite high and safe. The banks of the Nile. Do you notice as you're walking up the jetty towards the palace, you can see a glow of light from within. As the night is darkening, you can just make out baby crocodiles on the banks of the Nile. Baby crocodile, so cute, not threatening, cute baby crocodiles far away down on the Nile banks as you walk towards the palace. Walking towards the palace, you see the glow of the doors, and the doors are open. With a warm glow inside. You step forward into the palace, into a great hall. It's sumptuous and sensuous. You can see along one wall, it's a massive feast. Being prepared. You can also see couches covered in the most beautiful fabrics with the most comfortable looking cushions, beautiful lanterns, glimmering candlelight. Towards the area to have a relax. As you walk towards the couch, that you notice Sobek standing by it. And he's beckoning you to lay down. You can see his crocodile grin. You can see he's happy that you're there. And he gestures for you to lay down. Because in order for you to get a sense of what you really desire, first you need a really good sense of yourself. So you lay down on the sofa, and Sobek asks your permission to touch you. Sobek touches you with Sobek energy. Sobek energy which makes you feel alive. Sobek energy which honours and appreciates and enlivens your feet, your ankles, your calves. Your glorious feet, ankles and calves. Your ones, the perfect ones for you. Sobek energy touches your knees and thighs and hips and genitals. Sobek energy filling you up. Your body. Your body, just the right body for you, filling with Sobek energy, feeling more and more yourself as the Sobek energy feels so good, filling your torso and your chest, filling your shoulders, filling you up, making you somehow more you, somehow more alive, somehow more relaxed and comfortable in your own skin. Sobek energy filling your shoulders and flowing down your arms. Sobek energy flowing all the way to your fingertips, your hands, your brilliant hands, part of you. The perfect hands for you. Exactly who you are. Exactly what you need to be. Filling you up, making you more comfortable in your own skin. Aware of the tingly sensation of the deliciousness of it as it tinkles up your neck. Sobek energy filling your head and your mind. Sobek energy making you feel more comfortable in your own skin. The deliciousness of it. The pleasure of just being you. Pleasure of who you are right now, exactly enough. The pleasure of the energy centering you. You feel like there is a flame inside you, growing and filling you up with this vital energy. This vital energy of Sobek energy, this vital energy of the fire that sort of tingles out to the edges of your skin. So you're exactly you, filled up with you, comfortable in your own skin, thinking about you, where you are, what you want. And this is where Sobek then beckons you to come to the feast. Are you hungry? What do you desire? Takes your hand and walks you over to the feast table, which when you walked in looked like it was covered in food, but actually it's also covered in magical objects that represent your deepest desires, your wants, your wishes, what you truly want. You look across the table. You might see lots of things you want, or something might stand out. These are magical objects. And Sobek invites you to close your eyes and select. As you gently close your eyes and let the feeling of you, that tingly, powerful, definite feeling of you, guide your hands. You outstretch them to the table and select an object. As you pick it up, you know that this object represents what you truly desire. This object is the key to understanding what it is you want. And know that when you look at it, it might make sense straight away, or it might be mysterious. Either way, you need to accept it, and its meaning will come. To the desire, hold on to the feeling, open your eyes in the meditation and have a look at it. What are you holding? This is what you truly desire. This is Sobek's gift to you, the clarity of knowing exactly what you want. And the drive to get it. Feel how powerful it feels to know this is it. Sobek gently, magically transfers the object so it becomes part of you, so it goes inside you. It may be a desire that you carry in your heart. It may be an instinct that you carry in your belly. Wherever it goes, that's just right for you. Feel the power of that desire spreading through your body, knowing that you now have true clarity. This is going to give you clarity of what you want. Sobek smiling his crocodile grin. He's enjoyed your visit. I'm sure he'd like you to visit again. But for now, he takes you on a gentle stroll. The other side of his palace and into the garden. You you can smell the beautiful night flowers. You can see the torches burning. And you'll find a tree. A tree for you to lean against. A tree for you perhaps to sit and lean against on the ground. Sobek smiles at you, and you thank him. He walks back into the palace. Leaving you to relax against your tree. You allow your energy to follow the roots of the tree, growing roots down. Ground, deep down into the ground, through the soft soil, down to shale and rocks, and down through the water, through the mud, through the earth, all the way deep down, bringing you back to earth now, bringing you back to the feeling of your body and the surface that you're laying now, or sitting on, coming back to the waking world. Feeling strong and vital, feeling energized, knowing exactly what you want, having clarity over your desire, coming back into your body, giving your fingers or toes a wiggle, maybe taking a stretch in any way that feels good, delighting in being centered in you and knowing exactly what you want. In the waking world now. Back to you. I hope you enjoyed that. I always love to hear about your findings, what you saw, how you felt. I love to hear suggestions about what you'd like from me. I love your comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I wish you a beautiful day.